You're all familiar with ideal op-amps, their analysis and how useful they are. Now we will see how to make an op-amp using transistors.
And what's an op-amp? It is, the main thing is that it has two inputs. There is some ground here. So if I call this V1 and V2, okay, the op-amp responds to V1 minus V2. The output should be some large number times V1 minus V2, okay. So this is basically what we want to get, and we have some sort of model using control sources where we first get, sorry, this is Vd, we have some Gm times V1 minus V2, and then we had like a two-stage structure where we had this capacitor and all that stuff, okay. So, but at the heart of the op-amp we have this essentially a control source which responds to the difference between two voltages with respect to ground. Is this clear? So a MOS transistor is also a control source, but the common source amplifier we have now, if I have V1 here, it will be Gm times V1, okay. So, but I want Gm times V1 minus V2, okay. So how should I try to implement this? Now a MOS transistor does respond to, I mean, a voltage is always a difference between, difference of potentials between two terminals. A MOS transistor does respond to what? The voltage difference between gate and source, okay. So if I want Gm times V1 minus V2, what should I do? I mean, forget biasing for now, right? Everything I talk about will be incremental stuff. Later we will figure out how to bias these things. What should I do now to get Gm times V1 minus V2? What's that? If the incremental voltage here is V1 and incremental voltage there is V2, the current here will be Gm times V1 minus V2, okay. So it appears to be very simple. This is correct, this will work. I mean, let me just connect the drain to some ground, small signal ground. Again, I am only talking about the incremental picture here. Assume that the transistor is biased in saturation somehow. We have a number of techniques to do that, okay. So let us assume that. Now this appears okay. There are a couple of problems though. The main thing is, first of all, what is the input resistance of the resistance seen by V1? Infinity, okay. Yeah, the gate, no current, infinity. What is the resistance seen by V2? 1 by Gm, right. If you look into the, so if you set V1 equal to 0, the gate is grounded, and looking into the source of the transistor, you will have 1 by Gm, okay. So this is a problem by itself, right. What we wanted was an op-amp with high impedance into both terminals, basically no current should go into either of them, okay. So this looks okay, it gives us the difference, but the problem is the two inputs are asymmetrical, okay. So one has a very high input resistance which is desirable, but the other one has a very small input resistance which is definitely not desirable, okay. Clearly now you see that even if I have identical resistances here, it will not be V1, Gm times V1 minus V2, it will be something times V1 plus something else times V2, okay. So it doesn't work. This is okay. First of all, hope it's clear that this circuit gives you Gm times V1 minus V2 if it is driven like this. But the problem is the impedance looking into the gate and the source are different. So if the input voltage sources are non-ideal, which they will be, they have some internal resistances, we will not be getting the difference between the two voltages in the output. We will get some number times V1 plus some other unrelated number times V2, okay, some linear combination. That's not what we want. So how do we fix the situation? It's two MOSFETs. Yeah, we'll see, that has some other problems, but I mean, we will say that okay, we have kind of half solved the problem, right? This gives us the difference And as far as one of the inputs is concerned, it is all right. It has infinite input resistance. It's only V2 that is unsatisfied. So how do we fix the situation? So when you have so as far as V2 is concerned, its load has a very small resistance. Okay. So when you have a very small resistance as a load, and you have to drive it from some V2 which may have a very high input resistance, what do you have to do? What could you do? When you have a heavy load and you want to drive it with a source that is not able to drive that heavy load, what do you have to do? What is a block that you can use? What's that? Voltage controlled voltage source. You have to use a voltage buffer, right? So the whole point of the buffer is that if you have a heavy load, if you connect the load directly to the source, there will be so much attenuation that you hardly get any signal across the load. So that is the situation for, that's the situation for which the buffer is made, right? You use a buffer in between so that the load is isolated from the source. Okay. Is this clear? The motivation. So V2 now, it is driving the source of the transistor, and the source of the transistor presents an input presents a resistance of 1 by GM. Okay. So if this V2 is non-ideal, that is if there is some resistance in series with it, the actual voltage that appears at the source terminal will be very small. Okay. So we have to use a buffer for V2 so that no current is drawn from V2 either. Okay. Now no current is drawn from V1, we want V2 to be treated equally well. Okay. This is what we have to do. Now, regardless of the internal resistances of these sources, we will have V1 here, V2 there, and that current will be GM times V1 minus V2. Okay. Of course, the point is now I can't be drawing triangles like this. We have to put down the transistor level circuit. So, what is the circuit I can use there? Source follower. That's the voltage buffer that we know. Okay. Now I will show the internal resistances also. V1, this goes to the gate. I will call this M1. Okay. Now what I want is this picture. I will draw it separately just so that there is no confusion when I turn the transistors around. It has some internal resistance and I have a voltage buffer. Okay. And if I have to draw it with transistors, this is the voltage buffer, right? It's a source follower. Is this correct? Source follower is my voltage buffer and gives a gain of nearly 1, and it has a very high input resistance and a small output resistance. So I will use a source. This is now not being used yet. So I will just turn the circuit around facing the other way. Okay. So from our viewpoint, this is the amplifier. And this is the buffer, right? So what we wanted was to apply V1 to the gate of M1 and V2 to the source of M1. Now if you apply directly to the source, we said okay, V2 will be attenuated heavily. So we pass V2 through a buffer M2 and apply it to the source of M1. This is okay? I mean, this is how we synthesize circuits. I mean, many other ideas like using two transistors, those are also fine. You can try out and see what happens. Okay. So this is one possibility. Now we have to use our analysis machinery to see what exactly this does, right? Because we know that the source follower buffer is not ideal and all that stuff. Okay. So please evaluate the current here. okay? I mean, this is really, this represents the incremental circuit, okay? Assume that this transistor has a certain GM1 and assume that there is no GDS. That's the simplest case. And assume that this transistor has some GM2, okay? Just to be general, and find out what this current is. Figure out whether it really behaves the way we want it or not, okay? What did we want? What did we want? We want that current to be some number times V1 minus V2, okay? It should amplify only the difference. That's actually very important, right? It should sense only the difference. It shouldn't, if you throw V1 and V2 into any linear circuit, you will get alpha times V1 plus beta times V2, where alpha and beta are arbitrary. We want beta to be exactly minus alpha, okay? We want it to, that's what is meant by the circuit responding to only the difference V1 minus V2. So please find this current ID, I mean maybe ID1, and also this current ID2 in this case. Small signal, everything is small signal because I have not even shown how to bias it yet, okay? Simply assume that this transistor has some GM1 and 0 GDS, that implies saturation region. Similarly, this transistor has some GM2 and 0 GDS, okay? Please do that and find the currents.
What do you get? You get something times V1 minus V2,
you do, right? So it's actually a useful circuit. Only thing is, I mean, that proportionality constant is not GM1, okay? But that's okay, we stumbled across a very useful circuit. Now, I could have put down this circuit and asked you to analyze, but there is always good to have some motivation to why circuits are the way they are, okay? So you can always think of this as a common source amplifier M1 to which, or a transistor M1, and you apply an input to the gate and you apply a buffered input to the source, okay? So we will continue from here
in the following lessons,
build this up gradually towards the complete op-amp.